He gave those words of advice to his native countrymen who are undergoing tremendous upheaval in their lives. Although you are not facing the circumstances against the people of that time, I think that that advice is still applicable to you as you leave by this void and enter the world beyond the safety of our walls. Be not afraid. Be not afraid to reach out and help someone who is less fortunate than you. Be not afraid to try new things and experience the world and God's people. Be not afraid to stand up for what is right, even if you find yourself the lone voice in the wilderness. Be not afraid to use the talents and abilities you have been blessed with, but use them for others, not yourself. You will find true happiness. Be not afraid of the future because God has great plans for you. Be not afraid to step forward to assume the mantle of leadership because leaders you are. You have been trained to be so. Be truth seekers. In all you learn and in all you experience, look for the truth. Use the skills and talents you've been blessed with and have developed here to find the truth. Follow it. Live it. Share it. Make it yours. Incorporate it into your lives. Life was never meant to be complicated. It was meant to be enjoyed. It was meant to be experienced. It was meant to be lived to the full. But in our hustle-bustle world, it's all too easy to lose sight of what's important. Our faith, our family, our friends, our world, and our God. It's too easy to forget to live in the moment and instead live in the past or worry about the future. We miss what is before our very eyes, the wonders of life itself. Much is expected of you because much has been given to you. The world cries out for leaders, and leaders you have become. Yet in your zeal to lead and pursue all that life has to offer, stay grounded, be humble. Be real, be authentic, be honest, be loving. Don't just take from the world, give back to it. Give service to your fellow human being. We so desperately need you. We need you to use your talents, your abilities, so that the world becomes a better place because you are in it. Help others find the truth. Enjoy liberty, freedom. Help those less fortunate and in need. Be mindful of the needs of others and lend a hand wherever and wherever possible. Be selfless. In this final moment, allow me to leave you with one final thought. That is, choose wisely. Make choices that are sound and rooted in the foundations of your faith, because if you don't, you will not find true happiness. Choose to be good and stand out in a world that oftentimes tempts us to choose what is bad. Choose to explore and discover the world using the goodness, discipline, and knowledge that you have within. Choose to be remarkable, magnificent people in all you say and do. From the very beginning of your life, you've made choices. Your parents have taught you the difference between right and wrong. We've taken that firm foundation we built on it, helping you to realize that you are God's creation and He seeks for you to be perfect in Him. We all support you because we know of your goodness within. are good people, and never let anyone tell you differently. It's time for you to take what you've learned and go out into the world, choosing wisely. Choose to lead, because on you we pin our hopes for a better world, one where all people are treated with dignity and respect, and one absent of callous disregard for human life. You have within you to do great things, to solve many problems, and to create much good. You are bound to do so. I firmly believe that. You are leaving us now, and as in any family, we will miss you, your presence amongst us. There will be an emptiness in our hearts, but we rejoice in the fact that you are moving on to do greater things. We could not be happier before. Proud of you. We love you. Come back and let us know of the wise choices that you have made. Know that you can call on any one of us anytime, and we will help you the best that we can. We are but a phone call or an email away. We will always be there to lend you a helping hand. We listen here for words of support. I would like to close with Blessed Mother Teresa. People are often unreasonable, irrational, and self-centered. Forgive them anyway. If you are kind, people may accuse you of selfish, ulterior motives. Be kind anyway. If you are successful, you will win some unfaithful friends and some genuine enemies. Succeed. If you are honest and sincere, people may deceive you. Be honest and sincere anyway. What you spend years creating, others could destroy overnight. Create anyway. If you find serenity and happiness, some may be jealous. Be happy anyway. The good you do today will often be forgotten. Do good anyway. Give the best you have, and it will never be enough. Give your best anyway. In the final analysis, it is between you and God. It was never between you and them anyway. Farewell to you, seniors. Be not afraid. Be truth seekers. Be selfless. Be leaders. Choose wisely. Do it. In a moment, diplomas will be conferred. And once all the members have received their diplomas and they've been introduced as graduates, appropriate applause will be in order. But until that time, I would ask all of you.